There's a bright golden haze on the meadow. There's a bright golden haze on the meadow. The corn is as high as an elephant's eye, and it looks like it's climbing clear up to the sky. Oh, what a beautiful morning. Oh, what a beautiful day. I got a beautiful feeling. Everything's going my way.
7:30, 92.1 WROI, WROIFM.com. We are streaming audio live, RTC Channel 5. Streaming audio and video live, RTC Channel 4. That's why Scott is in the studio this morning. Good morning, Scott.
Good morning, Tom.
Welcome back.
It's good to be here.
Whenever Scott's smiling face comes in, we know it's Friday.
Was he here three times this week?
He was not. No, I actually expected him on Wednesday, but he did not appear on Wednesday.
He didn't show.
His coffee cup didn't get used till this morning.
Okay.
Dick Belcher's here from First Federal Savings Bank. Good morning.
Morning. A little breezy out.
A little breezy.
And it's going to be cool and breezy for the weekend.
Pretty much so, yes.
And Joaquin.
Dumping a lot of rain on the East Coast.
Yeah. No, you were just telling me before we went on the air, they're moving these military planes from the East Coast out to Grissom.
Yeah, Jenny and Scott were talking about that they're moving them into Grissom from the East Coast to get them out of Joaquin's way.
Okay. But the really big issue is whether Notre Dame's going to be able to play out there, play Clemson.
It's going to be a wet field no matter what.
Well, they can cover it. They're already talking about delaying it or canceling it.
Surely they'd have an inside stadium they could use somewhere, you'd think.
No?
Okay.
We're not using Barnhart Field on Saturday.
No? That's right. Yeah, bring them to Barnhart. Sure. Good idea.
RTC will cover it live nationally.
Yep. Good idea. That's why we keep him around. He comes up with these good ideas. Yeah.
I see Congress passed raised the debt limit for $18.1
trillion. A trillion just isn't what it used to be.
How much money is that?
I don't have any idea.
Well, you got $18 trillion of debt, and if you raise the interest rate an eighth of a point or a quarter of a point, it's a huge number.
Oh, absolutely, it's a huge number.
You think there's any reason now why the Fed's not raising interest rates?
That could be one reason
The president is on the phone calling the Fed chair.
Yeah, close the Fed today.
Okay. Well, I see presidential campaign for nomination goes on.
Keep going.
Sanders is closing the gap.
Yeah, he is on Hillary Clinton, right. That's right. Joe Biden hasn't even told us whether he's going to run yet or not.
Dangerous Joe.
I think a lot of people would gravitate to his campaign if he decided to toss his hat in the ring.
Yeah. Well, I see the television. They're keeping a stool open for him
for the
debate.
Good.
Yeah, just in case.
Just in case.
Is that this week, you know?
I don't know. Up.
So, well, they're saving him a seat.
Okay.
Trump's still leading on the Republican. And the second is Carson, Dr. Carson.
Carly Fiore is coming third, I think, and making a good run right now.
Mm-hmm. It's interesting. I think there's a message there to the politicians is because Trump and Carson, neither one are, quote, politicians.
Nor is she, right.
All right.
Right. She comes from the business sector.
Yeah. And we'll talk about her. She didn't do very well.
Well, I know, but it doesn't seem to have any effect on her campaign.
Well, that's because nobody knows.
Just you and I, right?
You and I. Now, well, if you can't be successful in business, you're probably not going to be very successful running a country.
That's exactly right. By the way, just a note we were talking about earlier, Sue just happened to bring this out. To be exact, there are 34 F-22s and 8 T-38s at Grissom from Langley.
Okay.
So now you know. And we thank her for that information.
Oh, yeah.
How about that?
That's invaluable.
Ah, 42 planes. That's right.
Well, like we say, oh, they're charging them a landing fee.
Per tire fee.
Yeah, per tire.
Okay. Penis cartoon by Charles Schulz was first published on this day in which year? 1950, 55, or 58?
That's a question Dina would ask as a cartoonist herself.
Yeah. Now, she says, if you don't like that one, here. She puts all these in. Both Captain Kangaroo and the Mickey Mouse Club premiered on TV on October 3rd. Of which year?
Oh, my.
50, 55, or 58. You know that, Scott?
I do not, sir.
We'll work on that, though.
Okay.
Yeah.
You know?
No.
She's too young.
I know the new age Mickey Mouse. That's on all day long.
Did you ever hear Captain Kangaroo?
Yes.
Okay.
Mickey Mouse?
Yes.
Okay. Peanuts.
The comic strip?
Uh-huh.
Yeah,
that's the
see?
One, sure.
Not what you eat. Jenny Moriarty with United Way adding a few things here.
But that reminds me, too, Jimmy Carter turned 91 yesterday.
Did he?
Yes.
I didn't know that.
Speaking
I knew
of peanuts.
Speaking of peanuts, yes, that's exactly what led me there.
Yeah, he was the peanut president. Okay, moving right along.
Yeah, we better.
Okay, sports. Volleyball team won again last night.
They did, yeah, 26-1.
Yep, beat Winamac. They're moving along.
Big match Monday against Tippecanoe Valley.
Aziz and Valley play tonight at Barnhart, Barnhart Field.
Barnhart Field.
Yes, sir.
Okay, it's going to be a great evening for football. Just crisp, good fall.
Senior night for the Zebras, too.
That's right.
The Z's are 2-4 and Valley's 2-4.
Right.
Culver, 2-4. They're at Caston, 1-5. North Miami, 1-5. They're at Wabash, 4-2. Wabash's got a better team.
Yes, they do.
And Winamac, volleyball played at Winamac. So, all right, now let's talk about the Colts.
Okay.
Luck hurt.
Yeah, I think so. He didn't take many snaps yesterday either.
Didn't he?
It's 2 days in a row, so we're going to have to wait and see what Sunday brings. I don't think he'll miss. I don't think he'll miss the start. He would not do that. How long he's going to be able to go is anybody's guess.
He got beat up pretty good.
Oh, my. He's been beat up in the first three games pretty good.
Yeah. Corso was the coach over at Ohio State. And at the end of the quarter, they were leading. And he got the team out in front of the scoreboard, and they took a picture.
He was quite the promoter.
Oh, he's funny
quite
guy.
Quite the promoter. Still is.
Okay. Well, as we mentioned earlier, Notre Dame is at Clemson, weather permitting. They're going to play about 8 o'clock on Saturday night. And Purdue travels to Michigan State, number 2 in the nation.
I tell you, the Boilers are just kind of struggling again, aren't they?
I'm glad you brought that up. 4-0. Struggling. Yeah, we are.
They've won one, though, haven't they?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
We played Ancilla.
Go Chargers.
Hey.
Go Chargers. We won that game.
Good. good win for the franchise.
Yeah. Well, we changed quarterbacks at least.
I know.
Blau did better last week.
Okay.
I'm reminding my Michigan State friends, and I have a few.
Well, there's several around the area, frankly.
Yeah. And back in 1957, when I was a manager of the Purdue team, Michigan State came to Ross-Ade Stadium, number 1 in the nation.
Ah.
We beat them 6-0.
Ah.
Francie Gutman was our quarterback. People out there don't ever remember Francie Gutman. Francie Gutman was a very successful quarterback for Purdue that year. After the season was over, he transferred to IU. Now, not to play football.
No.
He wanted to be a doctor, and he became a surgeon, and it's pretty unheard of now, certainly. But after we beat Michigan State on Monday, they let school out.
Really?
Yeah.
How about that?
You can tell how used we were used to being winning. Yeah. Fred Hubbard, the president, says you take the day off.
There
take
you go. The day off.
Now, if you beat Ohio State tomorrow, you're number one.
I'm taking the day off.
How about the students? Maybe.
Maybe.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, some upcoming events. The Friends of Fulton County Public Library book sale today.
That's right, first Friday of the month.
First Friday. Phyllis takes care of that.
She does. There. She does a great job.
Saturday, tomorrow, Cole Porter Classic 5K and 15K road race will raise needed funding for the Nickel Plate Trail.
Okay.
Race registration starts at 7:30. At the Peru Circuit building in downtown Peru.
Okay.
Some of you runners, go down there and get in that race. Barbecue chicken is served tomorrow, 11 to 6. Today and Saturday.
Okay.
Two days. At Faith Outreach Church. Grass Creek Lions Club is serving a fish and chicken supper, 4:30 to 7:30. Saturday at the fire station. You know, they have a new fire station.
They do, that's right.
I mean, they got capacity to put out many, many fires. Thank you to the U.S. government and taxpayers. Okay, Lake Manitow VFW Post 1343 hosts a hog roast 5 to 9 tomorrow. And this is an appreciation for people that help chip in and get... purchase a new Fulton County Veterans Van.
Okay.
Fulton County Council on Aging serves a spaghetti dinner 4 to 7 at the Fulton County Community Center on Pontiac Street. There also will be a bake sale. We got lots of food.
Lots of food.
Okay. Blacktop Cruisers, Red Hot Car Show, and the Fulton County Chamber of Commerce's annual chili cook-off next Saturday.
That's right. Big
right
one.
Here.
Yeah. Here it comes.
And Jenny's going to talk a little bit
about
that. Got a run there.
Yeah, we have the 5K race.
Okay. Okay, members of the Pleasant Hill United Methodist Church host a chicken and noodle. We got chicken and noodle.
Okay.
Harvest Supper beginning at 4:30 October the 8th. That's next week. Okay, of course, we got the mayoral debate coming up.
October 12th.
October 12th. And then we've got the WROI coming up.
October 30th. Right.
Okay. Tell the group out there how that's going to work.
Well, it's Candidates Coffee and Conversation. We started it in the spring with the primary. You'll have your show live from Giretti, 7:30 to 8, where we'll talk with the two party chairs. 8 to about 8:35, 8:40, we'll talk with the mayoral candidates, Ted Denton and Dick Rowe. And then we're going to finish up until 9 o'clock with the city clerk treasurer candidate, Shada Beeler and Bob Hayes. They're both going to be there. Clerk treasurer is an underestimated position. It's a very important position in city government, so we want to talk about that a little bit and find out exactly what they do and what their qualifications for that office are. Scott's going to be there with
RTC.
Coming.
We'll be live on RTC.
We'll be live on RTC. So 7:30 to 9, October 30th. Come on down to Giretti's. We'll even buy the coffee. What a nice guy.
What a day.
I mean, really.
Yeah, you guys are great.
What a nice guy.
Going back to sports, we mentioned about the Cubs are in the playoffs.
Yeah, they are.
You got to talk about that. That doesn't happen very often.
It doesn't, but they're back.
And IU has a baseball player. What's his name that plays for the Cubs?
Yeah.
He's a rookie there. Doing very well.
Cubs have had a good season. In fact, that division with St. Louis, Pittsburgh, and Chicago has been really good.
Yeah, well, besides the Cubs, we got the Cards are in it, and the Yankees are in it.
You bet.
Pirates are in it.
Get her started. I think this is the last regular season weekend, maybe?
It is.
Okay.
And then these playoffs and the World Series will go to Thanksgiving.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. Christmas.
Christmas. So yeah, you got to mark, you got to milk the media as much as you can. There. So.
That's right.
Okay, interesting to know the Boy Scouts sell popcorn 10 to 4 Saturday and Sunday at Kroger's.
Okay.
Rochester Optimist Club pumpkin stand on East 9th Street is open.
Going
you
strong.
You go by there, it's like a big supermarket
yeah.
there with lots and lots of...
Plus you make a little donation to the Optimist, they'll come down and decorate
absolutely.
Your building like we did here at the window on 8th Street.
We've got... more straw than we need.
They do a nice job each yeah. and every year.
And they've raised $15,000 to $20,000.
Sure.
Give it all away to mostly youth programs, and it's a great thing. Okay, Fulton County Community Foundation community support grant applications are sought. Community support grant assists organizations seeking funding in the range of several hundred to several thousand dollars. Applications are available online at nicf.org and are within the FCCF grant application packet. Deadline is October 9th.
Okay.
So if you want some free money.
There you go.
See that. Okay, Dale Summers, local farmer, passed away yesterday. Our condolences to the Summers family. How about some flowers to Tom Mate put together that
another great Kiwanis
Festival.
Right.
He does a great job.
11th annual.
Yeah. He and Shirley Willard do not know the word no.
That's right.
No, nope. Shirley, no, we're not going to get to that. No, Tom, we're not going to do that. Okay. Money news.
Yeah.
Staples. They're going to be closed on Thanksgiving this year.
Oh, okay.
Remember last year they had the big box companies
right.
and they were opening Thursday morning
early.
At 6 a.m.
Right.
And that was a big controversial thing. Well, Staples have already announced we're not going to be open on
okay.
Thanksgiving.
That's a good thing.
Sinclair Broadcasting is buying WSBT South Bend.
Right.
And the standard phrase on all of these acquisitions, there will be no changes. Dow was off 12 yesterday, closed at 16,272.
A lot of uncertainty out there.
Yeah, it was a tough month.
Yeah,
quarter.
Tough quarter. Right.
I've got an interesting words of wisdom along
okay.
that line a little bit by somebody like Mark Twain said. Okay, come on down to First Federal today. We'll be glad to see you. We're open from 8:30 to 5. ATM is always open. You can also bank with us anytime from anywhere with your smartphone or tablet and our mobile app. You can also deposit a check by taking a picture of it front and back. And oh, it's just magic.
It is.
It's just magic, yeah. Okay, interest rates are staying flat. Nothing happening
okay.
there. And we already alluded to the fact that you get $11 trillion of debt. You're kind of shooting yourself in the foot to raise the interest rates.
Right.
However, it will happen. If you come on down and see John or Ben and they can talk to you about maybe refinancing your present mortgage, or if you want to build onto your home
sure.
And make it bigger.
Good time to do all that.
Redo the bath, redo the kitchen, you know, make it wife approval.
Good time to do that.
Yeah. What are you laughing at?
No comment.
I learned a long time ago it's very important to have a good kitchen.
Right.
Yes, yeah. I agree. Yeah. Lots of counter space.
Okay.
There you go.
We got her. Keep in touch with what's happening by following First Federal on Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram. First Federal is FDIC insured and equal housing lender with an NMLS number of 3999 or 27.
That's the one.
Okay, we're legal now.
We are.
We have
totally
got
legal.
Everything taken care of.
Totally
well,
legal.
Jenny Moriarty, you're the executive honcho of United Way.
Yes.
And the program, the campaign has begun. Tell us about what your goal and objectives are and how you're running the program this year.
This year, we kept our goal the same at 100,000. We were just shy last year. We just raised just a little over 90,000. So we were almost there. We're going to get it this year.
Okay. Enthusiasm.
Yeah, I like that. That's
we were so close, just so close. And we have an incentive, too. I was telling Dick earlier, with the Indiana Association of United Way, if we raise 10% more than we did last year, which will put us to the 100,000, they will match that 10%.
Excellent.
So that's a huge amount that can help on top of what we raise to help with other agencies and community impact. So that's a big goal. We're asking anybody who gave in the past or any new ones, just 10% more, you know, gave $100, $110. So that's kind of what our goal is. We're working for that.
No, that is your goal.
That is our goal. That's right. Yes. Okay. Yes. That is our goal.
Okay. All right. What agencies are involved this year?
When
you make a contribution in United Way, unless you designate otherwise,
yes,
where do the funds go?
Right now we have Boy Scouts of America, Court-Appointed Special Advocate, CASA,
awesome,
Council of Aging, Helping Hands, Manitow Center, the Retired Senior Volunteer Program, RSVP, Salvation Army, and United Ministries Outreach. So those are the ones that we are supporting right now. We do have others that have approached us for next year that after we have our agency meetings, we'll kind of go from there. But which is a good thing because they know that we are impacting the community and they're wanting to be a part of us. So.
Okay, remind us how the campaign works and what's involved.
Well, we have several ways you can give. We have just individual people. We send out letters. Anybody can come in and make a donation. You can mail in a donation. The big way we give or get money in is through employee donations. We go with different businesses, particularly First Federal. They are our right now our largest contributor. We go in and employees can do a certain amount out of their paycheck. And that comes in quarterly. Normally we get it sometimes monthly. That is a huge way, and a lot of times businesses then do a donation themselves, which helps tremendously. Those are kind of the main ways. We do fundraising also with the 5K, but.
Okay, tell us about the 5K next week.
5K, we run it with the Chili Cook-Off and Red Hot Show. We kind of grabbed onto that. This will be our 10th year for the 5K race. It starts at 9:30. It's over on 7th and Monroe. We're still taking registration. You can register up till that day. We have shirts designed. Team Pride did it, and we have sponsorships on the back, and we have a ton of the Riddle kids come out. Charlene Swank keeps dropping off registers. She's like, I got more kids coming. The kids love it. They have fun,
sure,
shirts. You know, they get medals. They love coming out running, so it's always a fun day. Hopefully it's not too cold for it this year. Last year's a little bit chilly, but yeah, it's a great way to get the kids out, get everybody out. And it's not just a run, you can walk it. We don't care. It's both. We want everybody out there.
Okay, tell us about the United Way, the makeup of the board, and how do you function, and how do you determine how much money each agency gets?
Well, we are ran with a board. We have about 10 right now. We're always looking for more board members. We want to get up to 15 is our max. And within that, we do have agencies that will apply. They have several things of paperwork they fill out. We review it, and then if we accept them as an agency, which we do after that, then when we do allocations, they submit a bid pretty much of how much they would like, what they're using it for, how they're going to spend it, what they're all about, and then we review that in accordance what we raised from the prior year. We do the allocations after we raise the money. Then we set up how much we give can match what they have asked for. And then we pay them quarterly after that.
Is this the main fundraiser for a lot of these groups?
Yes. Well, yes.
They can also do some fundraising on their own.
Yes, they can.
Yeah,
they
okay.
can. Yes, they can. We just ask that they don't do it while we're trying to fundraise.
Exactly, right.
So kind
right.
of September through November, we kind of say, unless, and they come ask. CASA one time had a cornhole tournament. Not a big deal. We don't normally care, but we're trying to raise money for
right.
you.
Right, exactly. So.
Well, that goes back to when United Way was established, and before that it was a community chest, and it was brought out specifically to help these organizations maybe that aren't as large as some, and give them a chance to get money, and
yes.
and give a chance that when you make a contribution to United Way, you're giving to all these organizations.
Yes, yes.
And you already mentioned about the payday checkoff. That's I know has worked really well.
Yes.
And if you've got companies out there that are interested in this, they should contact you.
Yes, they can contact me at the office or Nancy. She's always up front. The number's 223-8929. We're in there every day, so.
Well,
not Saturday and Sunday. Sometimes, though.
But through the week.
We're there through the week, Monday through Friday.
Okay, give us that address again.
It's 722 Main Street. We're just right beside Webb's Pharmacy.
Okay.
Will you put the thermometer up again this year?
Yes, we'll probably put it up in a couple weeks.
Okay.
Yes, yeah, the big thermometer out front. Yeah,
kind of a good way to keep tabs on what's happening with United Way.
Yes, and we want it at the top this year. We're going to get there.
Campaign ends...
We'd like for it to end around Thanksgiving time. We're always open for it to keep going. Normally by January, we definitely want to cut it off, but we're open. We're never going to say no.
Okay.
Exactly.
That's a good policy.
Yes, never say no.
For a group that is not part of United Way, but maybe down the line somewhere would like to be, they just need to apply?
Yes, okay. Yes. So we have a couple that came to us, agency this summer. They're going to apply in December and review it, and I'm sure it'll work out because we don't really ever say no to anybody that needs help.
How'd you decide to get involved with United Way?
I actually, when the job came up, I was perusing the paper and saw it, and I'm like, this is a perfect fit. I always wanted something to give back. It helps teach my kids. I get my kids involved in Day of Caring. My husband helps out. It's just a good way to give back to the community. I've always enjoyed that, and it seemed like a perfect fit. So.
Good.
Well, we appreciate your work.
Oh, I love it.
And
good.
The economy's improving, and so you should have no problem getting that $100,000.
No.
And along with and then $10,000 more coming on matching funds.
Yes. Yes. That'll be great.
That'll be good.
Yes.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, it would be good.
Thank you, Jenny, for stopping by this morning.
Thank you. Yeah,
okay, our trivia this morning was about the Peanuts cartoon.
Right.
When was it first? You don't need to leave.
You're still part of the show.
Well, yeah, we may run out of things to talk about.
Oh,
right.
No.
That's right.
That would never happen.
You might have to sing your song. Remember we talked about? No.
No, you don't want to hear that.
She sings a song?
No.
Well, you know, she might want to here towards the end of the program. You never know.
Okay.
I'll talk about football or something else.
All right. Let's talk about Peanuts.
Peanuts.
Okay.
What year was it first published? 1950, 55, or 58?
What do you think, Scott?
50.
I'm going with 50.
Okay.
Jenny, what do you think?
55. You
okay.
55.
No, 50.
50.
Wow.
Hey.
Okay. Second verse.
All right.
Both Captain Kangaroo and the Mickey Mouse Club premiered on TV on October the 3rd of which year? 50, 55, or 58?
What do you think, Scott?
58.
Yeah, 55.
I'm going to say old 255. I got it.
That's right, 55.
Yeah. There you
it's
go.
It's amazing what you learn on this show.
It is amazing. Absolutely amazing.
Yes.
Okay, now, we talked about the instability in the stock market.
We did.
Okay. Mark Twain says, you know, we just turned into October, and he says, October, this is one of the peculiarly dangerous months to speculate in stocks. The others are July, January, September, April, November. Mark Twain.
Mark Twain would say something like that. He was very good at that.
Thank you, Scott.
Dick Belcher, thank you very much.
Jenny,
thank you. Scott, thank you for being here from RTC on the First Federal.
First Federal Savings Bank is Rochester's only locally owned bank. Stop in today to start a new checking or savings account. Learn more about our online banking options or sign up for Go Green Checking, the checking account that pays you back every time you use your card. Stop in today to see why local banking is better banking. First Federal Savings Bank, serving Rochester and surrounding communities since 1966.